Was it the initial script that latched you, the character, the fact that you'd be with M. Night? What was the initial appeal?
Mostly, I really love working, so when something is done, I'm always looking for something else.
Uh-huh.
And Night is really the thing that maybe you can practically sight unseen and do it. And I had a really wonderful conversation with him and decided to do it, more so than the script itself. But the notion that the character that I would play would have an integral involvement in the storytelling and not simply an interesting character there because she's interesting, but there for a reason. And when I heard that from him, I decided to do it, to work with Matt. And then it just kept getting sweeter as they hired more and more actors to come in and join us. Toby Jones, and after we had been shooting, Paul Davis came and joined us. It's incredible.
Yeah. It is an incredible cast. Did you know exactly what was going to happen, the entire thing, or did they only feed you that first episode and let you develop it from there?
Well, I think it was different for different people. I only knew I didn't know the books, so I just was told the arc of the whole story.
Oh.
And then they told me who was involved, and it was really the combination of this shattering twist in the show that no one could talk about, and the quality of the actors involved obviously goes without saying. So that was the thing that really got me on board.
Does it also help that it's a short run? I mean, 10 episodes?
It really does help. I mean, it's a big thing, particularly coming from the UK. You know, you've got family back home, you move everyone over. So the fact that it's contained is very reassuring.
Plus, you both have such busy film careers. It's like hard to juggle everything, isn't it?
Yeah, we're all superstitious. I'm all superstitious about saying we've got our very busy movie careers. Very busy. But yeah, it's true that both of us have done many different kinds of projects. And I don't know about Melissa, but I thrive on contrast, so I don't want to be stuck in one thing.
No, just because there's something quite striking about seeing your character in the nurse's uniform. Can you talk about putting that on and what kind of a nurse she is and how that makes you change your performance?
Yeah, costuming is always extremely important to me, and I knew that I was going to be playing the nurse, and I had lovely conversations with our amazing costume designer. And we were so much on the same page. There's a whole mystery to be unraveled about when our story is taking place. And there was something about a style of a period of clothing that, quite frankly, looks well on me. And so Mary and I decided this sort of 40-ish informed style of the nurse's uniform. Very specific about things I heard, and she responded amazingly to me. I prefer clothing that has a weight to it, and not be too gossamer. That wasn't going to help me be here. So the fabric, even, that the nurse's uniform is made of is a really important part of the nurse Pam's
You it's, always, it's always music to your ears when you hear that your character's wealthy.
There was also an incredible collection of directors that directed the different episodes. How did that affect you? I mean, you weren't handled by the same person for each episode.
I found that very challenging. It's not what I am used to. Then the actor is responsible for the character. Now, normally, it's the actor and the director. The director really is responsible for making a coherent episode in this country. And I found that a big change. You know, and it took a while to get used to the fact that, I have to put my hand on the ground. I really don't think that's a good idea. Well, that's a great idea.
The director also, I don't even know the directors realize this as completely as someone who worked on television with different directors for every episode, and basically all the television I've have been done. Very rarely, you know, maybe a director will do two or three episodes of a season, but not, you know, be that one person. The director is the captain of the ship without a question. And no matter what their talent or energy level is at, everyone on the crew, all eyes to the captain. So if they come in going, I don't know, well, maybe we'll do this, maybe we'll do that, you've got 10 days to shoot, sort of going, well, you're not sure what you're doing. And you get another director come in and they go, okay, this is so exciting, we're going to, and everybody, even the grips and electrics, get a little more excited. And it's a different, so the flow of the shooting day changes with the director, almost even more, in my opinion, than the look of the show.